Now, in the last class, just we discussed the basic concept about the nucleus and all, dear, where we're talking about the neutron, the proton electron hypothesis and your proton neutron hypothesis. And that only we are just talking about the discovery of neutron. So here from class 12A, as already they have covered this part. So just from anyone from class 12A, just tell me about the discovery of neutron. Hardik Chauhan. Hardik Chauhan, unmute yourself. Already this part you have already read, Nadia. That's why we are asking from you. Just tell me about the discovery of neutron. Or anyone from class 12A? Anyone from class 12A? Asta? Ujesh, so Varsha, do you have any idea about this one, dear? Varsha, just tell me, dear. So mainly here we'll be discussing, and in 12B, listen carefully because for you it is the normal class, dear. They have already covered this part. So tell me, Varsha. Then what was the main experiment? Just tell me the experiment part. So any idea regarding the experiment here? What, on what, dear? Bombardment alpha particles on what? Yes, so here what happened here? Now class 12, we listen carefully, dear. So in this case here, in the discovery of neutron, as I told you that when we are going for the constituent of the nucleus, so let me close the door. So when we are going through the particular hypothesis, we are talking about the constituent of the nucleus, dear. So when the constituent of the nucleus means the nucleus is made up of which particular particles and all. So for that only there were hypothesis was given, and the first one where your proton electron hypothesis, which were discarded as it relates to the dual part of the electron, that being it will be in the nucleus and few will be just outside the nucleus revolving around the nucleus to balance the charge, to balance the atom to be neutral, dear. So this hypothesis was discarded and all. So after that we are having the hypothesis of proton neutron hypothesis, which already I have told you. So in the case of discovery of neutron, here neutron was discovered by James Chadwick. And how it was discovered, dear, that he bombarded alpha particles. Alpha particles means helium, dear. He bombarded alpha particles with that beryllium foil with alpha particles, dear. And what he has observed, that when the beryllium is bombarded with the alpha particles, few radiations are emitting from it. Few radiations were coming out from it, and the nature of the radiation was neutral. The radiation's nature was neutral, dear. But when you're talking about the radiations, means in general term, we are having the concept that they must be photon and all some sources. But further, there are few laws, dear, like the laws of conservation of energy and momentum. This shows that these particular radiations won't be photons, dear. So now next question for class 12B is that, next class I want, I told you that here the beryllium, when he bombarded this beryllium with alpha particles, dear. He bombarded beryllium with alpha particles, which leads to the emission of some radiations. Which leads to the emission of some radiations, dear. And here, as told in your book and all that, here the conservation of this energy and conservation of momentum shows that this particular radiation won't be photons there. So next class I want that how the conservation of this momentum or the conservation of energy leads to the concept that here this particular radiations are not photon, and here the particular radiations are having in nature that they can knock out the photons beta from the light nuclei like nitrogen, carbon and all. From the light nuclei they can knock out the protons also. So here what happened that mainly whenever they'll be asking you regarding the discovery of neutron, mainly you will be focusing on that. The beryllium always bombarded with the alpha particle leading to the emission of your some radiations, and these radiations are not your photons. So here for this particular purpose we'll be writing that from the law of conservation of from the law of conservation of energy and momentum. So this part tomorrow will I want the answer from 12B dear, how this leading to the particular concept that this particular from the laws of conservation of energy and momentum these radiations these radiation are shown to be different from photons, to be different from photons, from photons dear. So how this particular conservation part is leading to the concept, this part today you go through some good books and all, and tomorrow we'll discuss this part dear. Now so here this particular radiations are having the nature that here these radiations are neutral, these radiations are neutral dear, and these neutral radiations are named as neutron. So here mainly the discovery of neutron was done by James Chadwick, and that too also by bombardment of your alpha particles with the particular beryllium dear, and that too also here you have to mention at last that the neutral radiation, the nature of the particular radiation is found to be, so here you can mention that the nature of this radiation, the nature of this radiation is found to be neutral, found to be neutral and named as neutron by Chadwick dear. So in class 12A now, 12A as already you have read this part. So can you tell me how the conservation laws of energy and momentum is leading to the concept that these neutral radiations are not photon dear? From 12A. From 12A. Pranay Jha. Already you have discussed this part dear. Just tell me. 12B you will be just preparing it dear. And 12th they just tell me, because here this radiation may be photon also and all, but when we are applying the conservation laws of energy and momentum, how it's leading to the particular concept that these radiations are not photons? Anyone from 12th A? Or let it be. So 12B you prepare it here, and tomorrow we'll be discussing in the class. Now so here this neutron are having the property that what dear? That are photons. And what about the momentum part? What about the momentum part? Any idea? So 12B you prepare it dear, and tomorrow we'll discuss. And 12A today you go through some good books, so you also dear. Now here this particular neutron, you know that the free protons are stable dear, but free neutrons are not stable. They are stable inside the nucleus, because in one mass this part is very very important dear, that here free neutrons are not there outside the nucleus. This cross means here few neutrons are not existing here outside the nucleus. Inside the nucleus they are stable, means here you can say that, or proper you can write down that outside the nucleus the neutrons are not stable. The proper word will be that outside the nucleus neutrons are not stable, but inside the nucleus the neutrons are stable, dear. Now after this part, few terms are there which is very, very important regarding your isotope, isobar and isotone, dear. This nucleus chapter is just a kind of theoretical chapter only, but few important topics are there just after it, like binding energy and all that part is very, very important for exam purpose. So here, just after the discovery of neutron, let us discuss about your isotopes, isobars and isotone, dear. Already in class 10th you are having the basic idea, so let us start with the first one, isotope. So Irappa Sagarika, any idea you are having about this isotope, dear?
Same atomic mass.
Then what, dear? Same atomic mass. Dev Sharma. Yes, Ashwin Praveen has written that have same atomic number. So here isotopes can be considered as. Or now let us confirm it from class 12th A. Suryansh Verma. So Barsa has told here different number of neutrons and same atomic number. So different number of neutrons will lead to what, Barsa? When you're talking about different number of neutrons, means here in general term, here isotope can be considered as they are the atoms of same element having same atomic number, but different mass number. Now, for example, suppose we are taking here carbon 6, here 12, and here carbon 14. We are talking about the isotope of carbon here. There are so many isotopes of carbon, and depending upon in last part only they have given you the role, the applications of the isotope and all. So here in carbon dating and all, which carbon isotope you are using, like such on. So here mainly suppose we are talking about the isotope of carbon, like here carbon 12 and carbon 14, dear. So here you are seeing that the atomic number of both the carbon are same. Now one thing you keep in mind, dear, that when you're talking about the atomic number means here it is equal to the number of protons or the number of electrons. So atomic number means here number of protons, or it can be considered as number of electrons, because this basic concept regarding the periodic table is already read by you in class 10th only. Earlier the periodic table, the elements were arranged on the basis of the increasing atomic mass and all, but that too also having some disadvantages, drawbacks were there, and further it was just on the basis of atomic number it was done by Moseley and all. That too also you've seen that how it varies with the frequency and all that part. You have already read in class 10, dear. So in this case, when you're talking about the atomic number, means it is the number of protons and or number of electrons. Because in order to maintain the neutrality of the atom is electrically neutral, dear. And here, the neutrons are also neutral. So the number of proton must be similar to the number of electron, so that the number of positive charges and the number of negative charges both will be canceling each other, and the whole atom will be your neutral. So now atomic number means number of protons and number of electrons here. And when you are talking about the atomic mass number, means here when I told you that they are the atoms of the same element having same atomic number but different mass number. So atomic mass, when you're talking about the atomic mass number, dear, so here this is represented by, does any one of you tell me how the atomic mass number is represented? Any one of you just unmute yourself and tell how the atomic mass number is represented here. represented as capital A, in terms of number of protons, electron or neutron, how will be writing it? Means here we can write down here number of protons plus number of neutron. Dear, this P plus N I am writing here. Write down that number of protons plus number of neutron part. So in this case here we are talking about carbon 12 and carbon 14. Here the atomic number is 6 only, dear. The mass number are different. So further you can explain here that, and 12B just along with the class you maintain your notes also. So here the atomic number, the atomic number is 6 in both the cases, and here the atomic mass number, the atomic mass number is your 12 and 14 respectively. Now so from 12 and 14 you know that atomic mass number, just I told you, number of proton plus number of your neutron part. So from here if we want to find out the number of neutrons, so here just tell me Chanchal Kumari from class 12B, number of neutron in carbon 12, number of neutron in carbon 12, then you tell me number of neutron in carbon 14. Quickly, Chanchal.
Ma'am, 6 उसमें कार्बन 12 में 6 न्यूट्रॉन्स,
6 एंड इन दिस केस दिया
8.
सो व्हाट यू हैव सीन इन केस ऑफ आइसोटोप, देयर आर सो मेनी डिफरेंट एग्जांपल्स आर देयर डियर, यू कैन टेक अदर एग्जांपल्स आल्सो, बट हियर वी आर गोइंग फॉर द सिंपल वन, कार्बन 12 एंड कार्बन 14. यू कैन गो फॉर द आइसोटोप ऑफ हाइड्रोजन आल्सो, अदर सो मेनी आर देयर. सो इन दिस केस हियर the number of neutron in the first case is 6 and this case is 8, means you can say that your isotopes are the atoms of the same element having same atomic number or different atomic mass number, just because of different number of neutrons. The number of neutrons is different, they are having same number of proton, or further you can write down here that they are having same number of protons and electrons. Both the cases 6 6, both the cases number of protons and number of neutrons are same, dear, but number of neutrons are different. So this is the case of your isotope, dear. You can further go for writing 3 or 4 more examples of isotope. So isotope means you keep in mind that different number of neutrons, because of this here the mass number, this atomic number is same, dear, but the mass number are different. Now after this isotope, dear, we are having the next one, isobars. From the name itself, isobars. So here, so let me ask from now, 12th A, Saumil Jain, Saumil Jain, just tell me what idea you are having about isobar. Same mass number but different atomic number. So in this case here you'll be writing, dear, that in case of your isobar, in case of isobar, they are having same atomic mass number but different atomic number. Now so here in general term Swami has told that same atomic mass number but different atomic number. Suppose we are taking the example of, here we are having nitrogen 14, the number is 7, and we are having carbon 6 and here the 14. Now look at the particular part, like in the first case of isotope I have used the statement here that they are the atoms of the same element. Now can I use Saumil Jain, Can I use the statement that in case of isobar, they are the elements of the, they are the atoms of the same element having different mass, same atomic mass number and different atomic number? Can I use this statement here? Like in the first case, I have used that they are the atoms of the same element because the number was same, because our periodic table is arranged in increasing order of the atomic numbers. If the numbers will change, the element will change here. So in this case, Somil, can I use the statement that here they are the atoms of the same element? Then whatever statement we are having? Yes, we can't use the particular statement here. Because depending upon the particular atomic number, as the atomic number is varying, your element name is also varying here. So here in this case, we'll be writing that these are the atoms of different element having same atomic mass number, but different atomic number. Now, from 12B, so here, Sneha Sharma, just unmute yourself. Listen, for the namesake, if you are attending the classes without giving any response, simply will marking their attendance zero, dear. And one more thing, your online test, which you are copying from your friends and other, we know that there are different sources for getting full out of full in your online test and all. These are hardly of no use. Your active participation in the class only just decide ki whether you are properly giving the answer or not. So without any interaction, simply your overall result or mark in the practicals, simply I'll be cutting it here. We are just wasting your time here, just asking from each and everyone so that your class will be interesting. Kuch bologe answer, kuch doge, but no use. Khushi Lodi, just I have not asked the question also. Just I am going to ask the question.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, dear, good. So Khushi has responded. Now Khushi, just tell me, in this case of isobar, what we can say about the number of protons, number of electrons and number of neutrons in both these two elements, dear? Does the number of protons are same in both the cases, beta? Here number of protons means the atomic number 7, here it is 6. The yes, Hajibin Praveen has given the answer. No, number of protons are not same, number of electrons are also not same. Now what you can say about the number of neutrons? Khushi, number of neutrons means just atomic mass number minus atomic number. To find out your number of neutrons, this part you keep in mind. Number of neutrons is equal to A minus Z. Number of neutrons is equal to A minus Z, dear. So in these two cases, when you're talking about, in the first case, number of proton, we are writing here example, nitrogen 714 here. So here number of protons is equal to 7, which is equal to number of electrons. So number of protons and number of electrons are equal here. Now, and here number of neutrons is equal to, so now Khushi, just tell me beta, in this case of this nitrogen, just tell me the number of neutrons. Khushi, just tell me number of neutrons here. This atomic mass number minus the atomic number, A minus Z.
7,
dear. 14 minus 7, 7. Now similarly, let us go for finding that of carbon 14. In case of carbon 14, dear, number of protons / electrons will be equal to 6, and number of neutrons is equal to 14 minus 6, equal to 8. So both the part you can compare here, that here neither your proton electron number nor your neutron number are equal here. Like in the previous case, there we are having the number of proton and the number of neutron, number of electron, both were equal in the both the cases. Means number of proton is equal to number of electron only. But here in both the cases, isotope part, they were equal to each other. But neutron number was different. But in this case, they are the atoms of different element here. So the all the three, proton, electron, and the neutron of this particular two cases here, they are not same. So here also two, three more examples will be writing. This will be homework for you for 12B. Now, so after the concept of this isobar, next one we are having isotones. So 12B, anyone is having any idea here? Next part is regarding isotones. Chanchal, what dear?
Yes, ma'am.
Same number of? Yes.
Number of neutrons are same.
Yes. So here, beta, we are using the particular statement. So listen carefully. The statement plays an important role here. Here in this case, we are using that the nucleides, means here the neutrons are present in the nucleus and all. Earlier, we have used the word that atoms of same element, atoms of different element and all. So here, we are using the word nucleide. The nucleides which are having the same number of neutrons are known as isotones. So here, we can write down that nucleides having same number of neutrons are known as isotones. Now look at the example. Example we are taking, suppose here oxygen 8, 16 we are taking, carbon we are taking here 6 we are taking, and suppose 14 we are taking. Now look at the example. Oxygen we have taken 8, 16 here, and carbon we are taking here 6, 14. In both the cases, your atomic number here, one is 8 we are having, here it we are having 6 dear. The mass number is 16 and here the mass number is 14. So here in this case, if you are talking about the number of neutrons in oxygen 16 is equal to your 8, 16 minus 8 dear. And in the case number of neutrons in carbon 14, again 14 minus 6 is equal to 8 dear. So here the nucleides, they are having the same number of neutrons inside their nucleus dear. The number of neutrons is equal to same only. This wire is also a problem. The number of neutrons are same dear. Now for 12B, just now we have discussed about isotopes, isobars and isotones. So just Neha, unmute yourself dear. Neha,
yes ma'am.
Now just you recollect all the three together, isotope, isobar and isotone dear, quickly. And I think that I hope that you won't be doing any cheating and all going through the notes. Whatever just now we have discussed here, from that only you just tell me, what about isotopes? Jaldi, she left the meeting only. This is the main, just you have no use dear. That's why the teachers are also forced to ask from only few students, and then time your parents will be saying that they're doing partiality and all. Neha joined the meeting.
Yes,
so Neha,
ma'am.
Am I audible to you? Neha, so leave it. Saurabh Meena, and for 2-3 days just I am observing Saurabh, that you are just doing the login and all, and nothing response you are giving. Saurabh, last two classes of the same thing you have done. Saurabh Meena,
yeah ma'am, I am online.
Just tell me, just
am I audible?
okay, Neha, leave it now. Saurabh, just tell me all the three, you just tell me quickly. Isotope, isobar and isotone, quickly dear.
I'm आइसोटोप्स एटम्स ऑफ सेम एलिमेंट दे आर हैविंग एटॉमिक नंबर
सेम
डिफरेंट
एटॉमिक
एटॉमिक
नंबर
नंबर सॉरी सॉरी सेम एटॉमिक नंबर बट डिफरेंट मास नंबर.
यस रियली गुड. नेक्स्ट वन कम फॉर द आइसोबार.
एंड आइसोबार्स इन आइसोबार्स क्या एंड आइसोबार्स डिफरेंट एटॉमिक नंबर बट सेम मास नंबर.
ओके डियर दे आर द एटम्स ऑफ डिफरेंट एलिमेंट एंड आइसोटोन्स.
इन एंड आइसो
सेम नंबर ऑफ न्यूट्रॉन्स डियर.
न्यूट्रॉन्स.
नाउ जस्ट आफ्टर दिस वी आर हैविंग क्लास में आपका. ओके ओके सो टाइम इज देयर डोंट वरी. सो हियर नेक्स्ट पार्ट इज रिगार्डिंग द मास एनर्जी इक्विवेलेंस डियर. सो नाउ एज ऑलरेडी 12th ए हैज डन दिस पार्ट सो लेट अस हैव डिस्कशन विद 12th ए स्टूडेंट डियर. व्हाट आइडिया यू आर हैविंग अबाउट द फेमस रिलेशनशिप गिवन बाय आइंस्टाइन. What idea you are having about the mass energy equivalence? Ritu Sharma. Ritu Sharma, just tell me whatever is known to you about the mass energy equivalence. So here, few people are giving the answer that E equal to MC square, Varsha, Pragya, and this Chirdes and all Sharma. So here just others also in 12B also I know that this particular relationship is known to each and everyone. Here Sajibin, Praveen and other also giving the answer. E equal to MC square, dear. The famous relationship given by your Einstein. The mass energy equivalence means together this particular relationship is very, very important, dear, because it leads to the unification of two conservation law together. Means we are having the conservation law for your energy as well as the conservation law for mass, dear. Like mass can neither be created nor be destroyed. So here in this case, when you're talking about the energy, energy can neither be created nor be destroyed. It can be transformed from one form to another form. So earlier, before this relationship was there, the mass, the conservation of mass was separately known to us, the conservation of energy is separately known to us. But this relationship leads to the unification, means togetherness of both the conservation law. Means it leads to the unification of the two classical laws, which already known to us, conservation or laws. That is your conservation of energy and mass. So here both the laws of conservation of energy and mass together is unified in the case of the formula or the relationship E equal to MC square. So according to this particular relationship, dear, E equal to MC square, this relationship shows that the particular expression part is told by each and everyone. But here the main part is that in any relationship, like here when we're going for your nuclear energy and other thing, dear, whenever, so here this particular relationship shows that in any relation, if a particular amount of mass is disappearing or whatever, same amount of energy will be appearing. Miss, now it's not like that here, like mass was conserved as mass only, energy was conserved as energy only. But now through this particular relationship, dear, we can have the idea that the mass can be conserved in the form of energy also, energy in the form of mass also. Means in any such particular relationship, what any mass appearing or disappearing can appear as energy and vice versa, dear. This is very, very important. Or in normal language, one statement is also given for this particular relationship. So let me ask from now, 12th A. So 12th A, Ujesh, a famous statement which is just bacche rat lete hain usko beta in case of this MC square. What was the statement? That mass can be converted into energy, energy can be converted into mass. Means together when we are talking about the conservation law, dear, here both mass and energy we are considering together only. Now, so as I told you that in any relationship, here main part is that in any relation, sorry, in any relation, the amount of mass, the amount of mass disappearing will appear as energy and vice versa. So here this relation lead to the simple language, it leads to the conservation of together mass and energy. So here it leads to conservation of both mass and energy together, dear. So here this part is very, very important. So any amount of mass disappearing will be appearing as energy, or any energy part, amount of energy disappearing will be appearing as mass only, dear. Now what is the main reason behind this, how this mass is converted into energy and all that part is mainly important here. So here in this case, one relationship in class 11th only you have read about. Now let us discuss with Rahul Singh. Rahul Singh, just unmute yourself. Rahul Singh, you are having idea about the rest mass. Rahul Singh, no use. This Pragya, now just Pragya, just tell me dear, we are talking about how this particular part will be leading to this, because this mass defect, actually in relationship what happened here, mass defect term already a teacher has been used and all. I am asking that in this case the mass defect only appear as energy, dear. Now here C stands for the velocity of light. Now in class 11th, in the chapter like first one, the dimension analysis part and all, there were relationship was given to you about the rest mass and something. Do you have any idea about the rest mass? So what idea you are having about the rest mass, dear? Okay, first tell me the relationship part, dear, then we'll be telling about rest mass. M equal to n naught, m naught upon 1 minus b square upon c square, dear, where c stands for what? The velocity, yeah, the velocity or the speed of light, dear, and this m naught stands for the rest mass, dear. So this is the relationship given as m equal to m naught upon under root 1 minus b square upon c square. Now so just tell me what you are observing whenever a particular object is in motion. What you can say about the mass of a moving object? Mass never changes, but this relationship when it is given to you that F, others please unmute yourself. M naught upon under root 1 minus b square upon c square, dear. If the velocity of the particular object will be equivalent to that of the velocity of light, then c square cancel. 1, 1 minus 1 will be 0. Now look at carefully. You told that mass is constant and all, but we are talking about the mass associated with the motion of an object. We are talking about the rest mass. Rest mass of an object is defined as the, if suppose we are taking a frame of reference. Frame of reference means, in normal language, this part is known to you, dear. So in a particular frame of reference, if the particle is at rest, then the mass of that particular particle is considered to be your rest mass. But here we are talking about that what will happen to the mass of a moving object. Anyone from 12B? Anyone from 12B? Here, just suppose, just I'm giving you the hint also. Suppose V is near about equal to C or equal to C only. Under that condition, M equal to M naught upon 1 minus C square upon C square, cancel out. Here, M naught upon 1 minus 1, dear. So m naught upon 1 minus 1 under root means here m naught upon 0. Something upon 0 and 0 upon something. Versa. जीरो अपॉन समथिंग एंड समथिंग अपॉन जीरो, इन्फोनाइट नॉट डिफाइंड मींस हियर इट रिलेट्स टू इन्फोनाइट डियर. ठीक है, नाउ इन दिस केस नाउ यू जस्ट कंपेयर दिस पार्ट हियर आई हैव गिव यू द हिंट आल्सो कि एज सून एज द वेलोसिटी ऑफ द मूविंग पार्टिकल और द ऑब्जेक्ट इज नियर अबाउट इक्विवेलेंट टू द स्पीड ऑफ लाइट यू आर सीइंग दैट द मास ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर ऑब्जेक्ट इज बिकमिंग इन्फोनाइट डियर. सो हियर यू हैव द आइडिया दैट व्हेनेवर ए ऑब्जेक्ट is in motion there is what loss in the mass or the mass will increase. Yes, that is the main part required here. So whenever here a particular object is moving, the moving object will have more mass as compared to the rest mass, but it is not observable because the speed of the particle, and we are talking about the speed of light, it can be observable, dear, only when you can observe it properly, clearly. When the speed of the object will be equivalent to that of the equivalent to the speed of light, dear. So this is very very important part. So always after writing this part, 12b, just write down this part, dear. And after this one statement is there, which is very very important, you just write down that part. Here I'll be writing that a moving particle or object, whatever you can use the statement here, object will have more mass. Just a few minutes, ma'am. More than that of the rest mass, and it is only observable when the speed of light is equal, the speed of the object is equal to the speed of light. Under that condition, it is clearly visible to us, dear. Now, so today mainly we have discussed about isotopes, isobars, isotones, dear. Then about the discovery of neutrons and just about the mass energy equivalence, which is further will be discussed tomorrow. Tomorrow, binding energy part and this mass energy equivalence part. So here, now class 12A, you'll be marking your attendance in the announcement part, dear. And 12B, just quickly attend to your oracle, dear. 12B. So thank you to this class 11th A. Now you can leave the meeting, dear, after marking that.